In the case of the human being, there is the magnification of good and evil and the biological kingdom. See, all the automatic stimulations of the animal kingdom will be intellectualized in the individual birth, in the human birth. Many of the instincts are intellectualized in the human individual. For example, fear. Fear is only an instinct in animals, which is given by nature for self-protection. Whereas in the human beings, it is magnified by intellectualization. The result is many of us are haunted by fear of the future. So, we have more causes of disease than the animals have. The second thing is, the animals cannot misbehave with natural functions. It cannot eat when it is not hungry. It cannot drink when it is not thirsty. It cannot mate when it is not season. Whereas in the human being, the case is different. So, the causes of disease in the human being are much more than the causes of disease in the animal kingdom. Because we have the capacity to rectify and also the capacity to misbehave. Whereas the animals have no capacity to rectify, so nature protected them from misbehavior. So the causes of diseases in animals are more of evolutionary than of individual. And when a period of disease occurs to an animal, it exists in an area where disease is caused. And there is much telepathic and astral infection from the human beings to the animals. For example, when a husband and wife live under very high tension in a house, the dog in the house reflects it. Because by nature, the dog cannot have very high mental tension. Such things cause diseases to animals. Like that, there are many factors to be considered. But we can always remember that little children and animals are susceptible to diseases because of our odd behaviors, especially emotional stress and outbursts. Yes, yes, please. Person, okay. Of course, there is truth in the statement, but you should be careful, not always true. Many times it is true. Many times it is true. Yes, I have the experience of it. I know it. In many cases, it is so. Of course, if the person accepts. Brothers and sisters who have gathered here, I very much thank the hosts of the evening at first, whose affection, kindness, and hospitality I am enjoying every year, and with whom I have developed much closeness. All these years, one thing has become common with myself and my hosts, that is a hearty and warm reception in a cold evening. And today I am expected to speak something about health and yoga. To speak about health, there is no much matter available, but there is much to do for us than to speak or know. Because health is not something which we have to know. It is something which we have to enjoy and realize and experience by doing more, not knowing more. If it is about disease and its cure, we have much literature in the world and less of results enjoyed by human beings. But our object of this evening is not the science of disease and cure, where much is there to learn and less is there to do. It is about health that our hosts asked me to speak. So there is less to speak and more to do and follow. And about half of what we are expected to do to maintain our health, every one of us know. And if we begin to put into practice that half which we already know, we will be 50% more healthier than we are. And automatically, the rest of the 50% will reveal itself to us without any universities and academic education. To know about disease and its cure, we require big, big institutions and universities, because we have to spend much money over it, because it is a disease to spend much money. And afterwards, we can behave quite commercially with people in earning much, much money. But to know about health and to do it practically, to regain our health, and re-establish our original health, and see the children and grandchildren in our house are born and bred up in health, so that they may not know much about disease and its cure. It doesn't require any expenditure of money, and also there is nothing much to commercialize and put it into practice and take much money from the clients. That is the difference between the science of health and the science of disease. Nowadays, the medical education is too much polluted with the science of disease and its cure. We have almost forgot what is health and how to practice it. Once again, for the past 50 years, there is the healthy movement in many countries of the globe. And people like our professors have started the campaign from many directions. Once again, to remind us that there is a science of health different from the science of disease and its cure, a science which is essentially positive in its nature. And it is our privilege to know and follow it. And there is very little to learn and much to do. Every step of it is to do something and follow. Otherwise, what we know will be as useless as any other subject.
Ambos.
Now, I will deal this subject in two or three layers of its existence. The first layer is understood in the following way. Our health depends upon our behavior with certain aspects of our life. Our behavior with food and drink, with sleep and rest, and the ratio between work and rest, and our behavior with sex. These are the main headings which are directly responsible for our health or ill health. And if you add a little of yoga training, the information is supplemented. First of all, if we can make a selective way of our eating and drinking, which we already know for a very long time, which awaits the day from which we begin to practice. So the few facts are waiting in us for the day, because we already know it. Have a selective way of food. You can have certain principles based on common sense. For example, cooked foods are less serviceable to you than uncooked foods to maintain you healthy. Cooked foods to maintain your health. If we depend mainly upon cooked and boiled foods, and gradually minimize the uncooked and raw foods. One can observe how the health goes down gradually. The converse is wonderfully true. If you gradually reduce the number of items of cooked food in your diet and replace them with uncooked and unboiled foods, you can see how your health is improved. Remember that getting cured of a disease has nothing to do with health getting improved. Any doctor on the street can cure your disease, but no doctor in the world can improve your health. See, the first is negative and the second one is positive. The first one is throwing your responsibility upon the doctor. The second one includes taking responsibility of yourself. So don't confuse the curing of a disease with the improvement of health. When you feel very happy with you, when you feel very happy with others, when the number of unhappy situations in your life are being reduced, and when your intake is improving, when your taste for food, drink, and life is increasing, if you are not tired of work or life or living, that is the sure sign of health. Until these things make their appearance in you, until you find life enjoyable, not in the sense of 1 hour or 2 hours or one day enjoyment, which we can call the conditioned enjoyment, but there comes a day when you feel life itself is an enjoyment. That is the only test to know that you are more and more healthy. You don't feel the burden of your life. You do not feel the heaviness of your body or mind. You will know what ease and comfort is, irrespective of your age. This is what the great people mean by health. Every part of your body is a beloved and faithful servant of yours. The matter in your body is obeying the force in your body, and the matter and force in your body are obeying the consciousness in your body. That is what is called real health. When your mind is conditioned by the force in you, the force which we call emotion, and when you suffer from emotional outbursts now and then, when you feel oversensitive and nervous, and the matter in your physical cells conditions the force and mind in you, so that whatever you eat and whatever you drink will condition your mind, body, and force. That is the typical sign of ill health. Even though the doctor accepts that you are not having any disease at all in you. So for your health and disease, you are the test and you are the judge, not any doctor. And the first attempt should be with food. The quantity of uncooked leaves and greens and salads, legumes and roots, especially roots like carrot, if you gradually increase these items and make it a point that uncooked cereals form a part of your daily diet, you can eat uncooked cereals in any eatable form you like. For example, some people soak them in water and keep for 24 hours until the cereals germinate. Then they eat. Or sometimes the cereals may be taken in the form of flour mixed with honey, mixed with honey, just as they do in India. Anyway, the main regular item should be cereals, among which if you have uncooked wheat, you will develop a health which nobody can believe the change in you. And the unboiled milk, which you think a bit difficult in Occident, because I think as a general rule, milk is polluted even in the cow in the accident. Therefore, it is not so very safe to drink milk that are not boiled. That is what some people express to me as a practical difficulty. But if you can manage to produce a microbiotic cow in your own garden, then you will have milk which is healthy to drink without boiling. But we in countries like India and Africa, it is safer and easier to get such milk. And milk products can also be taken, like butter, etc. And if these items are increased, and if the cooked foods are decreased in number, this gives a very good, wonderful stimulation to the health. Especially the oil fries and the butter fries should be avoided. And the dehydrated foods should be avoided, like powdered milk, custard products, and preserved foods, especially fruits and legumes preserved in vinegar and other things. These are the things that cause arthrose to many people. And when half of the reason for arthrose happens to be the fridge in your house, the other half is dehydrated and preserved fruit. When foods unduly preserved for a long time in the fridge are used, gradually your health begins to degenerate and lead to three types of diseases, one of the three types of the diseases. One may be towards arthrose, any complications of the bones and the joints, because it affects the periosteum. Periosteum, that is the surface tissue of the bones. Yes. The second is, it gives you a tendency to produce worms in the alimentary canal. Worms of all sizes, from the very small size, which we call the pinworm, to the size of snakes. Unless there is the tendency to produce snake, no one can inherit or have the contagion of worms in the stool. Some people will have small worms in stool, and we are told that there are many small cysts of those worms germinating into those worms. That is the cause of these worms, that is what medical man says. But what is the cause of the cyst forming in your alimentary canal? If contagion or infection were to be the cause, why some people get it and some do not get it? The answer is not ready with the most modern medical science man even today. If I am wrong, if there is anyone who gives me a satisfactory answer to this, I am ready to join as a student under him and make him conduct my own researches. But in any one of the countries, I could not get an answer till today from any medical qualified man. But the question is, the tendency to produce worms is there in some people, it is not there in some people. Only those people will be infected, whereas the infection dies and is destroyed if it happens to go and reach the person who is really healthy. So if we habituate foods that are preserved for many, many hours in the fridge, changes take place in our constitution, and the changes produce tissue changes in the physical matter. Understand, our constitution is not at all physical, something more. Our constitution exists above the physical matter of the physical body. And when once it is disturbed, it produces a distortion in the chemistry of the physical tissues of the body, the cause of which the medical man is not yet qualified in the 20th century to find, because the clinical tests belong only to the physical matter of the body. The technician can give you only the causes in the matter of the tissues. He can never speak of your constitution, which is above and beyond matter. You are not matter, but matter is being produced through you. Just as your hair is coming out of your head, and your head is not at all your hair. Similarly, the material body is coming out from you every moment, and you are not at all any part of the material tissues. As long as the constitution is in order, the chemistry of the physical cells is properly being produced. When once a distortion is produced in the constitution beyond matter, then the production of the tissues will be distorted. The biochemistry is changed, and it cannot be rectified by physical means. The science of disease and its cure will never help you. It is only the science of health, if you know, will help you. If there is something wrong in the electric current, if you replace the wire with a new wire, can it be cured? Once again, the fuses will be burnt. As many times as you repair, and so many times the fuses will be burnt. Because the contacts were faulty, you can never rectify on the physical plane. Electricity should be rectified on the mental plane of the electrician who is working, and he should make a proper connection once again. Similarly, the constitution, when once becomes faulty, by faulty foods, especially foods preserved in the refrigerator, they may produce worms in the alimentary canal, and parts of the tissues of the body separated in their functions from other parts, gradually growing into what finally the doctor calls cancer. Understand that what the doctor calls cancer is only the final stage and not at all a disease. So it can be prevented by your healthy way of living, and it cannot be cured. That is why in many, many cases, cancer cannot be cured, though cancer can be prevented in 100% of the cases. So avoid taking refrigerator preserved foods, especially those placed in storage for a very long time. Whether you are capable of preserving foods in the refrigerator or not, it is not at all proper to use food after 24 hours, especially organic animal foods like milk. And more so, if you alternate hot and ice-cooled things eating. For example, you take coffee after a lunch and then ice cream. Some people take ice cream and then coffee. Or very strong soup, then ice cream, then coffee. A warm soup, ice cream and coffee. That speaks the degree of our lack of common sense. What happens to the tissue of the teeth when you heat it and then cool it and then heat it? The result is premature decay of teeth, which is quite common in the Occident, which an Orientalist like Indian or Japanese will be surprised to know, because it is a matter of statistics that 80% of the uncivilized Indians have natural teeth until they die. But those who are westernized, they have decayed teeth in India also.